The armour is a reconstruction of a mid-15th century armour. This armour comes from a knight that died a few years after the Battle of Agincourt. He'd fought at the Battle of Agincourt. He was a close associate of Henry V. He returned for an expedition in 1417 and then died in early 1418. However, his wife remarried sometime in the mid-15th century, and around the time that she remarried, she had the effigy made of her late husband. And the armour that the mason depicted was the armour of that time. So though he died in 1418, the armour is much more likely to be mid-15th century. But this shows a number of features that are particular to England. So we wanted to see how that armour actually functioned when it was put together. There's very little surviving real armour from 15th century England, so we have to rely on the funeral monuments, the effigies of fallen knights.
Fra da vi først var over at fotografere gravmælet i Porlock Church, der ligger i Sydengland i Devon, og så til den stod færdig, der er gået 2 år.
Vi har heldigvis at gøre med stenhuggere, som har vidst, hvordan en rustning så ud. Så de har fået hugget dem ud, så at man kan se, hvor lameller sidder, hvor nitter sidder. Og alle de her detaljer sidder rigtigt rustninger, så det er rigtig godt evident materiale, vi har arbejdet med. Problemet er, at man ikke kan kigge ind i en stenrustning, om jeg så må sige. Så der har vi måttet støtte os til materiale fra for eksempel italienske rustninger. Og så har vi haft stor hjælp fra en bog udgivet af kuratoren på Wallace Collection i London, Tobias Capwell, som har brugt 8-10 år på at forske i de her engelske rustninger, helt specifikt i de her engelske rustninger.
But very pleased with what we saw today. It was interacting well. I was pleasantly surprised how well it fitted and how comfortable he was moving in it.